We've looked at this world and the temptation of this world and how it makes many of us go the wrong way. We've looked at the flesh and the struggle with the flesh and how many people have never surrendered their body and made it a living sacrifice and said, God, I want to be holy, blameless before you. I want to die to the flesh. I want to be crucified like you were. And now this last thing that he warns us in this passage, he says, neither let us tempt Christ as some of them tempted and were destroyed by serpents. What they did in this great thing that causes many of us never to enter the promised land is they had already been to the water two times. The first time Moses had thrown a tree in, sweetened the waters they could drink. The second time he had struck it with his rod. The third time they said, can God bring water? After every day being in the wilderness and God providing food, going out and picking up manna, and at night when it's freezing, God has a cloud, a pillar of fire heating, and then we run out of water and they go, can God provide water? What is that? It's the one thing that I believe keeps more people from entering into the promised land, unbelief. I believe that one of the greatest giants we face is men. That we face in the American church today is our unbelief. We have God's word. It's written to us. And yet how many of us believe it? How many of us believe the promises that God has said? We see the miracles. We see all the stories. History has proven everything in the word to be true. But yet many of us, when we read a passage of scripture, we simply don't believe. I believe that the thing that touches the heart of God is a man that will say, God, you and your word said it. I believe it. I'm going to live my life that way, and I'm expecting you to do what you said. Can you imagine if I said to you, man, hey, call you on the phone and say, I really want to get together with you. Meet me tomorrow for lunch. How disappointed I'd be if I show up for lunch at Subway and you don't show up. I call you on the phone and say, Jake, where are you at? Phil, where are you at? I didn't think you meant it. Hey, you didn't believe me? Men, the Bible is the word of God. Everything that he says, he will do. If we're going to enter the promised land, we must enter with faith and we must believe. Unbelief angers the heart of God. Let's go deeper. Let's read our Bibles. Let's believe the word. Let's stand on the word. And let's walk so that we may enter into the promised land.